Hello students, today let us take up the first lecture on secondary metabolites. Let us start with the introduction. Metabolites are commonly defined as organic compounds synthesized by living organisms through enzyme-mediated chemical reactions called metabolic pathways. Metabolites in plants are broadly grouped into primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. Primary metabolites are organic compounds which are essential for the growth and development of plants. They are found universally in the plant kingdom and function as components or products of fundamental metabolic pathways or as precursors for the synthesis of secondary metabolites and include carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids, etc. In contrast, secondary metabolites are compounds derived from primary metabolites without involving the metabolic pathways common to all plants, and they are not essential for normal growth and development of plants. Secondary metabolites are synthesized in specialized cells at particular developmental stages of plant, and their occurrence is usually restricted to a particular taxonomic group, genus, species, or family. Secondary metabolites are generally produced by plants as defense chemicals, and they also often include colored, fragrant, or flavorful compounds which play a role in interaction of plants with other organisms like plant pollinator, plant pathogen, and plant herbivore interaction, etc. Let us now learn about the biosynthesis and major groups of secondary metabolites. Plant secondary metabolites can be divided into three major groups based on their biosynthetic origins. The first one is the terpenoids, second is the flavonoids and allied phenolic and polyphenolic compounds, and the third group are the nitrogen-containing alkaloids and sulfur-containing compounds. The biosynthetic pathways for synthesis of secondary metabolites derive mostly from precursor compounds of primary metabolism, including compounds derived from protein or amino acids, carbohydrates or sugars, and lipid or fatty acid metabolism. The various secondary metabolites are synthesized by biosynthetic pathways which are interconnected to one another. The terpenoids are synthesized from acetyl coenzyme A through mevalonic acid pathway, while the phenolics are synthesized in plants either from acetyl coenzyme A via malonic acid pathway or from erythrose 4-phosphate and phosphoenol pyruvate via succinic acid pathway. On the other hand, aromatic compounds such as phenols, flavonoids, and some alkaloids are synthesized from aromatic amino acids, and other nitrogen-containing alkaloids are also synthesized from aliphatic amino acids. The secondary metabolites in the plant occur as complex mixture of compounds, and their biosynthesis is influenced by many factors during development, in addition to stress. Secondary metabolites may also be synthesized as inactive metabolites known as phytoantisipins, which are transformed into active products when required by the plant. While the secondary metabolites which are synthesized in response to the invasion of plants by various pests are termed as phytoalexins. Next is the occurrence and compartmentation of secondary metabolites. The patterns of secondary metabolites present in plants vary depending on the species, the developmental stages, and the stress situations occurring in the plant species. These differences are due to the differences in the metabolite biosynthesis, the regulation of genes encoding the biosynthetic enzymes, and in the differences in transcription factors and transport proteins present in plants influenced by the genotype and stress conditions. Therefore, it is difficult to generalize patterns of secondary metabolites for a given plant species, although some metabolites can be confined to a certain plant species like the betalains in the caryophyllales, glucosinolates in most species of Brassicales, and polyacetylenes in the Asteraceae and Apiaceae families. Although secondary metabolites can be synthesized in mostly all plant organs, including the roots, shoots, leaves, flowers, fruits, and seeds, the secondary metabolites are commonly stored in specific compartments consisting of specialized cell types or whole organs in the plants. The concentration of the secondary metabolites in these compartments is generally very high, which is essential for efficient defense activity against the herbivores. Lipophilic compounds are commonly stored in the membranes of organelles or in the endoplasmic reticulum, although some compounds such as the alkaloids berberine are stored in specific storage vesicles. On the other hand, hydrophilic compounds are preferentially stored in vacuoles and in the inner parts of organelles or cytosol, as well as in the extracellular space or apoplast. The hydrophilic compounds mostly accumulate as inactive precursor substances in vacuoles and are activated chemically and/or enzymatically. Compartmentation of the secondary metabolites serves three implications. First, it may help in preventing the plant itself from direct contact with the toxic compounds since the metabolites are commonly released from the storage compartments only after wounding or attack by other organisms. Secondly, the biosynthetic pathways are also compartmentalized in plants and transport processes are involved for metabolite movement. Thirdly, the target molecules for the secondary metabolites may be present in all compartments. However, the target molecule is not always necessarily localized together with the active form of the compound. Let us now see the functions of secondary metabolites. Secondary metabolites play many roles in plants and the main ones are discussed here. First is they function in defense mechanisms against herbivores such as nematodes, insects or vertebrates, as well as against microbes and other competing plants by acting as deterrents or anti-feeding toxic compounds or by inhibiting germination and growth of competing plants. Next, secondary metabolites function as attractants to other organisms such as pollinators, sembans, predators, seed dispersers, etc. Thirdly, they may help in attracting animals for seed dispersal purposes by producing color and aroma compounds. The fourth function is secondary metabolites may also play a role in protecting plants against abiotic stress like ultraviolet or UV light and photooxidation, that is, oxidation reactions induced by light in plants. In addition, secondary metabolites play some roles in primary metabolism. Example, the metabolites located in the membranes of the plastids and mitochondria are necessary for electron transport chains and light absorbance. Let us now learn about the principal groups of secondary metabolites. The first group are the terpenoids. Terpenoids include the terpenes or isoprenoids and constitute the most diverse classes of secondary metabolites. Terpenoids represent a large family of natural products including flavors and fragrances, antibiotics, plants and animal hormones, membrane lipids, insect attractants and antifeedants, and mediator compounds of the electron transport processes, and they play major role in plant defense. Terpenoids are synthesized by a common biosynthetic pathway from acetyl coenzyme A or glycolytic intermediates through condensation of isoprene or C5 units, and the structure of terpenoids range from linear to polycyclic molecules and their size vary from the 5-carbon hemiterpenes to thousands of isoprene units as in natural rubber. Terpenoids are classified by the number of 5-carbon units present in the core structure as monoterpenes containing 10 carbon atoms, sesquiterpenes containing 15 carbon atoms, diterpenes containing 20 carbon atoms, and sesterpenes containing 25 carbon atoms, triterpenes containing 30 carbon atoms, and tetraterpenes containing 40 carbon atoms. First, let us see the monoterpenes containing 10 carbon atoms. Monoterpenes are terpenoid molecules with two isoprene units and have the molecular formula C10H16. Monoterpenes may be linear or acyclic or cyclic containing one ring in case of monocyclic or two rings in case of bicyclic. Monoterpenes may further be modified by oxidation or rearrangements to produce related compounds called monoterpenoids. Acyclic monoterpenes include compounds like osimin and the myrcenes and related compounds like geraniol, citral, citronellal, citronellol, linalool, helomon, etc. While monocyclic monoterpenes include limonin, terpenins, philandrins, terpenolin, p-cymin, and other derivative compounds like menthol, thymol, carvacrol, etc. On the other hand, bicyclic monoterpenes are represented by compounds such as pinene, which is the primary constituent of pine resin, carin, savinin, camphen, tosin, and other bicyclic monoterpenoids such as camphor, borneol, and eucalyptol. The next are the sesquiterpenes containing 15 carbon atoms. Sesquiterpenes are a class of terpenes that consists of three isoprene units and have the molecular formula C15H24. Like monoterpenes, sesquiterpenes and related sesquiterpenoids may be acyclic, example, farnesin, farnesol, or monocyclic, example, gingerbin of ginger oil, abscisic acid or ABA, humulin, etc. Then bicyclic, example, delta cardinin, capsidiol, caryophyllene, gamma etivazulin and guazulin, or tricyclic, example, longifolin, copaine and patchouli. The next are the diterpenes containing 20 carbon atom and sesterpenes containing 25 carbon atom. Diterpenes are a class of terpenoids containing 4 isoprene units or 2 terpene units with the molecular formula C20H32. Diterpenes and diterpenoids include biologically important compounds such as the plant hormone gibberellins, abetic acid, phytol, retinol, retinal, taxanes, samarin, etc. Sesterpenes or C25 compounds are compounds with 5 isoprene units. They are the least common group of terpenoids in plants and are mostly isolated from fungi. The next group are the triterpenes containing 30 carbon atoms. Triterpenes are compounds with 6 isoprene units or 3 terpene units having the molecular formula C30H48. Triterpenes such as limonoid and triterpenoids such as sterols, cucurbitacins and triterpenoid saponins of bitter tasting glucosides of milkweeds play important roles in plant defense and membrane structure. The next are the tetraterpenes containing 40 carbon atoms. Tetraterpenes are terpenoid molecules with 8 isoprene units and have the molecular formula C40H64. Tetraterpenes include phytoin and other biologically important tetraterpenoids like carotene and carotenoids such as the acyclic lycopene, the monocyclic gamma-carotene and the bicyclic alpha and beta-carotenes. The next are the polyterpenes containing N repeats of the C5 unit. Polyterpenes are high molecular weight terpenoid compounds having a C5N skeleton where N is greater than 8. The principal example is rubber, which is a polymer containing 1500 to 15,000 isopentanol units with nearly all the carbon-carbon double bonds having a C's or J configuration, while gutta rubber or gutta percha is another polyterpene which has its double bond in trans or E configuration. Let us now see the conclusion. We have seen that plants produce many secondary metabolites that are not involved in the normal growth and development of plants in addition to the primary metabolites that play a key role in growth and development of plants and perform important function in processes like photosynthesis and respiration. Being synthesized from primary metabolite precursors involving interconnected pathways different from the primary metabolic pathways and compartmentalized mostly, secondary metabolites play an important role in plant defense and contribute to long-term survivability of plants. They include diverse compounds like terpenoids, flavonoids, and allied phenolic compounds, and nitrogen and sulfur-containing compounds. Thank you.